Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. The colors today are presented by the second year Weeblows from PAC 200. They're in process down with the flag.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in the presentation of the colors. Color guard, advance. Scout salute. Prepare to post the colors. Post the colors. Please join me in the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Two. Thank you.
Please remove your hats or your hoots and join me in the singing of our national anthem. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our started here, we have Pastor Priest from Zion Lutheran Church here in Iowa City over on Bloomington Street, and he is going to bless our Oktoberfest.
All right.
Oktoberfest is an ancient tradition among the German Guten Morgen Vigadezinen, yeah? What we celebrate is the harvest and the diversity and the community, and this is just such a celebration here in Iowa City, the first of many annual festivals. So join with me and pray to the Lord of your life. Lord God, we give you thanks for the gift of this celebration, the gift of the people of Iowa City and the surrounding areas. We love traveling north and south on Highway 1 and east and west on Highway 6 to see Iowa golden with the treasure you provide. Likewise, the treasure of the people all gathered here and throughout the communities, knowing the blessing of the harvest and the longing for a marketplace. So in the midst of this celebration, bring to us joy and delight. We ask this in your name, O Lord. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Father, Pastor Priest. Okay, willkommen. My name is Wayne Nugel, and ich bin Zeremoniemeister heute. I'm the master of ceremonies. And while we get started here, the beer tents aren't going yet, but the root beer tent's gonna get started. And we have sort of an Iowa City celebrity here. This is J.D. Elberhasky. And he's gonna be involved with the root beer tent. You've been pretty well known for all your commercials for John's Grocery, you and your sister Jessica, right?
Yeah.
And I think you've been doing this a long time. You're not like 30 years old, are you?
No.
Okay, well, anyhow, I sort of messed around with a well-known song, and I'm going to sing it now, and this is for the root beer tent. Roll out the root beer barrel, we'll have a barrel of fun. Roll out the root beer barrel, we've got the blues on the run. Roll out the root beer barrel, now is the time of good cheer. Now we roll out the root beer barrel, for the gang's all here. Join J.D. Alberhasky at the root beer tent. Join J.D. Alberhasky over at the root beer tent. Join J.D. Alberhasky at the root beer tent. Now it's time to drink some root beer at the root beer tent. Okay, get to work. Okay, now we have music here on the main stage all day until 8 p.m., along with a host of kids' activities, contests, prizes, great food, art, and a long list of other happenings, all for the first time here in the Northside neighborhood of Iowa City. And we can't forget the 16th annual Brewfest hosted by John's Grocery and the American Heart Association. For the lucky ones with a Brewmaster's ticket, the Brewfest opens at 11 o'clock. For everyone else, you just have to enjoy all the other things, the food, activities, while you wait for Doug to open the gates at noon. The Sodafest is opening up as well as all the other areas of the festival. Iowa Roofing and Siding is giving away a free vacation over on the other side of Lynn Street. They're giving away a couple of bikes also today in the bicycle area across Market Street. So go check it all out. Well, we start off with the Old Capitol Chorus of Iowa City on the main stage here, brought to you by our good friends at Deary Brothers Automotive. Iowa City's Old Capitol Chorus is honored to open the Northside Oktoberfest. They are the local chapter in the Barbershop Harmony Society. For over 45 years now, they've performed a cappella barbershop harmony for holidays, Valentine's, competitions, and their annual show. For guys of all ages and background who simply love to sing, you are always welcome to their Thursday evening rehearsals. And I've had the pleasure of singing with them a few times over the years, and I know it's a lot of fun. And now, with this beautiful morning, please welcome the Old Capitol Chorus.
It's a brand new day and we're here to say we're gonna sing all out tonight. Some old, some new, some how do you do? We'll even try a tag, that's right. That's right. For a holiday will come your way if you let all your cares just fade. There's a new and exciting joy for you if you smile when you hear your song. It's a brand new day and we're here to say we're gonna sing all out tonight. So let's get going right away and we'll sing all we know.
Thank you. Tricia, it's a beautiful day here in on Lynn Street. Walking down Lynn Street, remember that wish. There's a song called My Perfect Game. When I was a kid, I would feel the pull of the blacktop back behind Kenwood School, and I'd grab my glove and my tennis ball, and I'd draw a strike zone up on the wall, and the stands were full behind the plate. Tender girls I could captivate. Big league scouts who never heard my name on the day I pitched my perfect game. You know, the first guy up I knew preferred fast inside, so I threw my curve and I struck him out, and it was for all to see his small part in history. And the sun did rise up above that field as one by one each batter yielded to the underdog approaching fame on the day I pitched my perfect game. Then of the ninth, you know, it was 3-2. One more pitch, high up and through. It was my fireball to that bully Mike. And the umpire called him out on strikes. And on their shoulders I did right. From that field as all the people cry, who was that little boy so all aflame on the day I pitched my perfect game? Thank you.
Yeah. With good things. And now as we celebrate the beginning of this harvest season, we give you thanks for this festive drink, for giving us the things we need, the hops and the malt and the barley seed, for the labor and the will and the knowledge and the skill to bring forth from your good earth this heavenly delight. We bless this keg and this fest in the name of God who creates, redeems, and sustains us all. Let our hearts rejoice in your bounty. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Bill Coleman to Oktoberfest.
And there will be beer.
There you go.
I'm frozen bacon beautyskite.
Rosa.
Thank you.
just south of Lisbon. Are you guys in the area here?
Yeah.
We're just off on. Yeah, like my brother. They made all those posters that are hanging up. They used to say the logo for everything.
We even have some of those around the store.
Are there any questions I can help answer?
They say I have the fastest tongue in the world.
I've had people that don't normally like ranger. I'm like, why are you a little limited?
Yeah, it brings the citrus out.
And that's dangerous.
Yeah, it can set you free shots.
Well, at this point, I get to introduce a number of the authors who are featured with these artistic pieces. Some of them have joined us here in Iowa City today, and we've got a laminated poster to commemorate the event, and I will hand a poster to each of the authors. The first author is Carl Klaus.
Thank you very much. I just want to deliver another line in celebration of beer and literature. Malt does more than Milton can to justify God's ways to man. So lift up a glass and drink to all of us writers and literature.
Thank you very much. Here you go. Our next author is Roberto Ampuero.
I arrived 11 years ago from Valparaíso, Chile. I have been living in Iowa City. Thank you very much, Iowa City. Thank you very much.
Samantha Chang is our next author. I don't think she's here yet, but I've got a poster for her. Our next author is a local favorite, Larry Baker.
Thank you, Matt, Mr. Mayor. I first met Matt when he was like 7 years old, which makes me feel incredibly old right now. Anyway, I want to thank Matt and the city and all the members of the selection committee for their support. I appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Congratulations. Our next author is Jacqueline Briggs Martin.
Thank you. I love Iowa City, and I'm so happy to have a permanent spot here on the north side. Thank you, Iowa City.
Our next author, another local favorite, author Stephen Bloom.
I've been here for 19 years. It seems like I've only been here for a couple of months. I appreciate the people of Iowa City. I appreciate Iowa City. I appreciate Iowa. Thank you very much.
Next, I'd like to introduce Sarah Pernaeus.
So does this mean we get free beer? Thanks, Iowa City.
And now I'd like to introduce Lori Erickson.
The book I'm being recognized for is Sweet Corn and Sushi, which is in Japanese and English, so I'm delighted to say, domo arigato gozaimasu. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And last but certainly not least, Kate Aspengren.
You'd think since I was last, I would have thought up something good to say, but all I can say is thank you very much for this.
These and many authors are celebrated with the bronze pieces you can see up and down both sides of the street. I encourage you to attend their readings today and to just check out the amazing public art that is now part of the Northside landscape. And at this point, I'll give it back to Jan, and have a great day, Iowa City.
Thank you, Mayor Matt. Now, we'd like to introduce Steve Maxson and Doris Parks of MaxCast, who are responsible for these incredible sculptures that you see as you walk around. Come on up.
Well, we're awful happy to be selected to make these bronze artifacts for the literary walk here. And I want to thank the Iowa City Public Art people, Marcia Bollinger, Wendy Ford, and Rob Decker, who the city engineer who helped us install these, and the architects at Confluence. And I want to thank the people at MaxCast who helped us work on these things, Randy LaCour and Mark Davis, Doris Park here, and a few other people too. It's kind of difficult at times getting this stuff done. There were a lot of stops and starts and stalls and things, but it was kind of challenging too. We came up with some new techniques and used some new materials that we hadn't used before, so we added a few things to our bag of tricks. So we kind of came out ahead on the whole thing, I think. We did a statue of Irving Weber down the street here a few years back, and Tom Muller wanted to immortalize important Iowa Cityans, and one of the Iowa Cityans he wanted to immortalize was Paul Engel, but Tom passed away a few years ago, so he's not pushing for that anymore, so maybe we need somebody else to get behind this Paul Engel statue idea, and maybe we can get one of those out here too. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. All right, before we conclude today, I'd like to thank John Coyne, who unfortunately couldn't be here today, for his artistic contributions to the signage, as well as Confluence of Iowa City, who designed the original concept of the Northside Marketplace Literary Walk. So as you enjoy everything that Oktoberfest has to offer for you today, be sure to attend our authors' readings that are going to be taking place throughout the afternoon. I know there's some schedules that have been handed out, and they will be at various locations, Riverside Theater, Teaspoons, The Haunted Bookshop, and RSVP. So thank you all again for being here to support our fabulous Northside neighbors. Cheers.
Okay, I have some announcements to make. I know there's a lot of food straight down from me down Lynn Street, but there also is a bunch of food down the alleyway past Hamburg Inn. We got food from the Pit, Hamburg Inn, and John's down to the east. Also, I want to make some announcements about the kids area. Right now, we have Ron Clark and Riverside Theater interactive play with kids. Throughout the day, we have face painting, pumpkin painting, temporary tattoos, West High Music, West High. My brother teaches at West High. West Music is helping kids make instruments. There are pop-up balloons, magicians, and Typhoon Balloons is over there. So there's a lot of stuff going over to the east side over here. There's just as much going on over there. There's stuff going around all over the place.
Thank you.
You want to say hi, Mom, I'm on TV.
Oh, yeah. You want a beer?
Yeah. How about a Blue Moon?
Blue Moon? Just the regular or the pumpkin?
Regular.
Ooh, that does sound good.
You can get a shot of it. Really well. Drinking on the job. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, it's a nice food.
It's great, yeah. It's quality, it's clean beer.
Yeah, it's, they use the burning milk trucks to move them.
How are we doing, Doug?
It's going kind of periodically.
Cheers for John.
To make here. This is a big one. The George's Beer Garden is open. The George's Beer Garden is open. Okay, we've got a couple of contests. We got to have some more contestants. We got the Beer Wench Run over by the alley by Hamburg Inn. We got to have some more contestants. And we're going to have a yodeling competition later, too. I should say, yodeling contest. Okay. So we've got our next music group up right now, and they're a good one. Let's welcome the Monday Night All-Stars. Monday Night All-Stars have been a part of the Iowa City music scene for nearly 20 years. Johnny Kilowatt and Uncle Led were original members of the Blues Instigators and began playing with Saul Lubaroff at the Iowa City Yacht Club Monday Night Blues Jam in the early 90s. Keyboard ace Bill Peterson, a.k.a. the White Tornado, and drummer Paul Kresiewicz have become major players of the Iowa City music scene and round out today's lineup. George's Buffet has been home to the Monday Night All-Stars for several years now and will welcome them back to kick off U of I Homecoming Week, Monday, October 17th. Michael and Missa Carr, Melissa Carr loved live music and have hosted numerous performers, including the band you're about to enjoy. Ladies and gentlemen, the Monday Night All-Stars.
You'd be late, Express. Now you show up smiling with your lipstick all a mess. Oh, baby, baby, baby. Oh, honey, I've got news for you. Your story don't ring true. Baby, I've got news for you. Story don't ring true. Baby, I've got
Wait.
I kind of lost
it. It's the woodchuck.
Oh, the woodchuck.
We made it into the end of the logo. It has all it.
How much wood could a woodchuck have? A woodchuck, a woodchuck, a woodchuck.
Thank you.
pounds of beer going over there. So do you get tickets when you're over there too? How many do you get?
I don't know what the cost on the tickets are. You get a certain amount when you buy, and then you can purchase more tickets.
Oh, okay. Because they said it's like $5 to get a mug here with the tickets. So I don't know if we're bought. You said it's like 20 over there, but 40?
Well, 40 if you wanted to come in at 11.
I got four tickets. Nowhere to put them. Nowhere to put them. No more four tickets.
We still have all of our.
Go!
Who's having a good Saturday Oktoberfest? Rock and roll. He told me to say something, I don't know what to say, so that's it. You guys might know this one, sing along. We do throw a cover or two in there once in a while.
Took a nice long